Hey everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Tech A11 by Usha and myself, Usha. In this video, I'll be demonstrating how to do screen recording in iPhone using inbuilt screen recording option present in iPhone with VoiceOver screen reader. iOS version that is currently running on my device is 15.4. So just follow these steps, okay? First step is add screen recording option to control center. In order to do that, open settings.
Settings.
I'll double tap.
Set.
One settings page is open. Keep flicking till you find control center option.
Search. Sign into your AirPod. Wife. Loop. Note. Set. Focus. Screen time. General. Button. Control center. Button.
Double tap.
Swipe up from the bottom of the screen to view control center.
So in this control center settings page, swipe. Swipe right.
Access. Allow access. Included controls. Heading.
Included controls. So there are basically two categories of heading here. One is included controls and another one is, let me set my rotor to heading mode.
Language, headings.
I'll flick down.
More controls, heading.
More controls, heading. I'll flick down again to check if there are any more headings.
Heading not found.
Okay, that's all. So the first one is
included controls.
Included heading. Controls and
more controls.
More
heading.
Controls. Okay.
Included controls.
So
heading.
Under this included control heading, you'll find all those controls which are included or added in control center. Okay. So let's swipe and check what are the different controls. Okay. I'll just swipe right.
Torch.
Torch.
Timer.
Timer.
More controls. Heading.
So I reached more control heading. As you can notice, there is no screen recording option listed under included controls heading, which means it is not included or added in control center. We need to add it. Okay. Let me tell you friends, like currently screen recording is going on, but in order to demonstrate this step, that is adding screen recording option to control center, I have deliberately removed screen recording option and I'm just demonstrating this step. Okay. So here, in order to add screen recording option, you need to just
more controls heading.
Navigate to more controls heading. So under more controls heading, whatever options are that are listed, whatever controls that are listed, whichever you double tap, that will get added to control center. So here specifically, I want to add or include screen recording option. So I'll just swipe and navigate to insert screen recording option and double tap. Okay, so I'm just flicking right.
Insert accessibility. Access. Insert alarm. Insert app. Apple. Insert calculator. Insert camera. Insert code scanner. Insert dark mode. Insert guided access. Insert hearing. But here. Insert home. But insert low power mode. Insert magnifier. Insert music record. Insert NFC type. And insert notes. No. Insert screen recording button.
Insert screen recording. Double tap.
Insert screen recording. Insert notes button.
Now what I'll do, I'll just navigate back to that heading that is included controls and check whether screen recording is now listed under that heading or not. Okay, I'll just navigate to that heading.
Describe headings. More controls. Included controls. Heading.
Okay, included control. Now I'll just swipe right.
Torch.
Torch.
Timer.
Timer.
Screen recording.
Yes.
More controls.
As you can notice, like screen recording option is now listed under included controls heading, which means it got added or included to control center. Second step is focus to the screen or the app that you want to record. Say for instance, if you want to record home screen, just get your focus to the home screen like the way I'm currently in. Okay.
YouTube podcasts settings.
Or say, suppose if I want to record some other screen, say,
apps with settings, active, settings, active, allow access settings, control, swipe up from the bottom.
Suppose if I want to record this screen, I'll get my focus to the screen which I want to record. So this is the second step. Get your focus to the screen or the app which you want to record. Okay. Next, what you need to do is just open control center. I'll just open control center.
Control center, airplane mode, switch.
Swipe and focus to screen recording option.
White blue mic meet select preview play neck lock sprite volume focus timer selected screen recording button.
selected screen recording. It is saying selected because currently screen recording is going on. When screen recording is not going on, it will just say screen recording button. Okay. So once you focus to the screen recording button, just flick up.
Open controls.
Once VoiceOver says open control, double tap.
Selected photos for everything on your screen.
Now here I would like to give four important instructions. Okay. Number one, let me navigate.
Everything on your screen, including notifications, will be recorded. Enable do not disturb to prevent unexpected notifications.
So it's very clear, like before starting your screen recording, make sure like all your notifications are cleared. Okay, otherwise all your notifications also will get recorded. And if you don't want any other notification to pop up while recording, just turn on do not disturb. Okay, so this is the first instruction. Second instruction is select Photos app as the location to save your recorded video. Okay, so here under this heading,
screen recording, heading,
screen recording,
period,
and just navigate,
selected photos,
photos,
telegram button, stop recording.
So here button. Two applications are listed for me, photos and telegram. So in your case it might be 2, 3, 4. So out of, I mean, let it be any application, but make sure photos is selected. Okay, so here
telegram selected, photos 5,
so photos
15, button
I have selected so that the recorded video gets saved in photo gallery. Okay. Third important instruction is regarding microphone. So let me navigate to microphone option.
Microphone on button.
So currently microphone is on, but when you try to do the screen recording for the first time, or when you switch off the mobile and turn it on again, and then you try to do the screen recording, that time this microphone option will be in off state. You need to turn it on if you want your voice also to be recorded while screen recording. Now I have kept it on because I want my voice also to be recorded while screen recording. Otherwise, if you keep this microphone off and try to speak, what happens is your voice will not get recorded. Only screen and VoiceOver voice will get recorded. So if you want your voice also to be recorded, then make sure you turn this microphone on. Okay. Last but not the least, fourth important instruction is before starting screen recording, make sure you put on your earphone or Bluetooth earphone. Otherwise, what happens is if you try to start the recording without wearing earphone, VoiceOver voice, which you are able to hear very clearly before starting the recording, as soon as you start the recording, VoiceOver voice will now go to earpiece, and hence you won't be able to hear VoiceOver voice very clearly. You need to keep the device very close to your ears in order to hear, but still VoiceOver voice will not be audible enough to do the screen recording. It will be very difficult for you to do the screen recording, as VoiceOver voice will not be heard clearly. Okay, I mean VoiceOver voice will go very low as it is going to earpiece. So in order to avoid that, make sure you wear your earphone or Bluetooth earphone before starting the recording. Okay, once you follow all the instruction, you are all set to start the recording. So just double tap on start recording. Okay, so in order to focus there, just swipe left from this microphone option,
stop recording button.
So currently this option is announced as stop recording because recording is already going on, screen recording is already going on. So before recording, this option will be announced as start recording, so you need to double tap on that. So as soon as you double tap on start recording, VoiceOver will say 3, 2, 1, and you will also hear a sound alert which indicates like, you know, screen recording has started. Okay, so as soon as the screen recording is started, when as soon as you hear the sound alert, what you need to do is you need to perform two finger scrub gesture two times in order to reach the screen which you have actually decided to record. Okay, so why two times? Because as soon as the recording has started, you will be in the same screen, that is
telegram button, stop recording
in
button.
The screen, that is the recording controls screen. So you need to dismiss this, right? So in order to dismiss, I'm performing two finger scrub gesture or Z gesture. So I'll perform once,
selected screen timer
button. So you will be taken to control center, so you need to dismiss this control screen, right? So again I'll perform two finger scrub gesture,
Settings. Control Center.
So heading. I have reached the screen which I actually want to do the screen recording. Okay. Once you reach the screen that you have decided to record, one tip I want to give here is, like, you know, before you start your actual recording, just be silent for 5 to 10 seconds. Why I'm saying this is, it will be easy for you to trim the video. Because as soon as you double tap on start recording option, from that point when you hear the sound alert, which indicates, like, you know, screen recording has started, from that point till you reach this screen, that is the screen you want to record, everything will be recorded, which is really unnecessary, and it will be easy for you to trim if you be silent for 5 to 10 seconds before you do your actual recording. Okay. In order to demonstrate this, now I'll be silent for a few seconds and then I'll do one small test demo recording. Okay. Hi everyone, myself Usha. This is demo for screen recording. So I'll just navigate on the screen.
Torch. Included controls. Torch. Reorder timer. Reorder timer. Screen reorder. More controls.
That's all in this video. Thank you. So this is how you need to do the screen recording. Once your screen recording is done, the last step is to stop the screen recording. Basically, there are two ways to stop the screen recording. Number one, focus to the status bar. Let me focus to the status bar.
Control center. Screen recording. Screen recording in progress. Mobile data. 4 of 4 bars.
Okay.
Signal
strength.
So
once you focus to the status bar, keep swiping till you hear screen recording in progress. Okay. Let me swipe.
Air mobile data. Screen recording in progress. 7:02 p.m. Button.
Okay. So once VoiceOver says screen recording in progress, once you focus to the point where VoiceOver says screen recording in progress, just double tap. Okay, as soon as you double tap, you will get a confirmation dialog.
Screen recording in progress. 7:00 mobile data.
Let's
four
focus
timer.
Somewhere. Yeah. So as soon as you double tap on screen recording in progress, you will get a confirmation dialog with cancel and stop button. So just double tap on stop. Screen recording will get stopped. This is the first way. Second and the most efficient way to stop the screen recording is just press the power button and lock your phone screen. Okay, so as soon as you lock your phone screen, you will also get a sound alert which indicates, like, you know, screen recording is completed. I mean, screen recording has stopped. Okay, so this is the best way. Just lock your phone screen by pressing power button. Okay, so I'm just pressing the power button to stop the recording. So friends, this is how you can do screen recording in iPhone using inbuilt screen recording option present in iPhone. Once screen recording is completed, the first question that would come to your mind is, where can I find my recorded video? You can find your recorded video in your photo gallery, as we have selected photos as the location to save our recorded video. Remember instruction number 2? I asked you to select photos as the location to save video. So you will find your recorded video in your photo gallery. Just ask Siri to open photo gallery, and when you navigate, you will find your recorded video. Or you can just open camera, then tap on photo and video viewer. You'll find your recorded video over there. Okay. And if you want to trim any part of the video, just save the video to files application, and in files application you can trim very easily. Okay, I usually trim the video by saving the video to files application. If not, you can just transfer the video to any of the video editing software and you can trim the video in that particular software. Okay. That's all in this video, friends. If this video was helpful to you, do give a thumbs up, share it, and hit the bell icon to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is Usha signing off. See you in next video. Take care and have a great day.